Let's see the molar elevation in boiling point. Suppose that molality. Molar elevation in boiling point means elevation in boiling point for one molar solution. Determination of elevation in boiling point for one molar solution, that is molar elevation in boiling point constant. So molality m, molality m is defined by the equation number of moles of solute, number of moles of solute into 1000 divided by mass of solvent in gram. Okay, suppose that, remember this relation, delta PV equal to KV into molar concentration, M. Okay, so molality is given by the equation number of moles of solute into 1000 divided by mass of solvent in gram. So mass of solvent in gram is represented by small m1. So number of moles, we know that the number of moles, how can we calculate number of moles? So number of moles equal to mass of solute in gram, mass of solute in gram upon molar mass, mass of solute in gram upon molar mass gives us number of moles of So number of moles of solute equal to mass of solute in gram represented by small m2, because mass of solvent we have taken here m1. So mass of solute represented by m2 and molar mass is represented by capital M. Molar mass represented by capital M. So number of moles we obtain m2 upon m. So we can write molality, that is m, equal to number of moles of solute is m2 upon capital M into 1000 divided by mass of solvent in gram, that is m1. So rearranging this equation, m equal to this m2 into 1000 divided by this m, now here the denominator m into m1. Now at this stage we obtain the equation for molality. Okay, equation for molality here. Now equation for molality here represented, but from the definition of elevation in boiling point, elevation in boiling point is represented by this equation. Elevation in boiling point is equal to delta TB equal to KB into M. So delta TB into KB into M. So delta TB, for value of delta TB is the KB into M. Value of M is here, we have calculated from the definition of molality. So value of KB is M2 into 100,000 divided by the capital M into small m1. Okay, and from this value of M, that is molar mass of solute, M is calculated. So M we rearrange here, we get here KB into M2 into 1000 divided by, so delta TB goes here, denominator delta TB into M1. So this equation gives the molar mass of solute. We can calculate molar mass of solute by this method, by knowing the delta TB, that is elevation in boiling point, and this method is called as ebulloscopic method for determination of molar mass of solute. So molar mass of solute can be determined by this method. Now see the terms, KB is what? It is the elevation constant for elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point constant m2 is the mass of solute in gram. Mass of solute in gram into 1000. Here elevation in boiling point and this is mass of solvent in gram. So by knowing mass of solute in gram, mass of solute in gram, mass of solvent in gram, elevation in boiling point and this boiling point elevation in boiling point constant, by knowing this term we can calculate the molar mass of solute. So m represent molar mass of solute. So molar mass of solute can be calculated by this method. This is the ebullioscopic method for determination of molar mass. So this is about elevation in boiling point. Second property. First property we saw relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second is the elevation in boiling point. Okay, elevation in boiling point. Let's see the third property, that is depression in freezing point. Depression in freezing point. Third qualitative property, that is depression in freezing point. Before that, we must know what is freezing point. Depression in freezing point. So freezing point is what? Freezing point. When we freeze the solution, suppose that water is in liquid state, and when you freeze, we decrease the temperature of water, then becomes ice. So this process is a freezing process. Okay, freezing process. But when it happens, at what temperature it happens? The temperature at which vapor pressure of liquid and vapor pressure of solid becomes equal. By decreasing the temperature, vapor pressure of solid and vapor pressure of liquid becomes equal. So when both vapor pressures becomes equal, the temperature is called as freezing point. So first we can define freezing point. Freezing point is the temperature at which vapor pressure of liquid and solid phases are same. Vapor pressure of solid and liquid phases are same. The temperature is called as freezing point. Okay, and depression in freezing point is represented by notation delta Tf. Depression in freezing point, delta Tf. Okay, so delta Tf represents the depression in freezing point. Now look at again for solute. Again for solvent and solution. Solution and solvent. So vapor pressure is directly proportional to freezing point. Vapor pressure is directly proportional to freezing point. Means vapor pressure increases, freezing point increases. Vapor pressure decreases, freezing point decreases. So we know that vapor pressure of solvent is greater than the vapor pressure of solution, because after adding solute, solution vapor pressure decreases. So vapor pressure, we saw this point in relative lowering of vapor pressure. So vapor pressure of solute, solvent, is always greater than the vapor pressure of solution. So vapor pressure is directly proportional to freezing point. So freezing point of solvent is greater than the freezing point of solution. Freezing point of solvent is greater than the freezing point of solution. Suppose that freezing point of solvent is represented by T0F. Freezing point of solution is represented by T0F, and freezing point of solution is represented by Tf. Freezing point of solution is represented by Tf. So we have to minimize the smaller value from larger value. Here which is larger? Here which is larger value? This is smaller value. So difference we can calculate. So this delta Tf is the
depression in freezing point. It depresses. Freezing point depresses after addition of solute. So here depression.
So depression in freezing point is represented by delta Tf, which is the difference of freezing point of solvent minus freezing point of solution.
Freezing point of solvent minus freezing point of solution.
So delta Tf
here represented in this way. Now
it represents delta Tf.
To understand it properly,
let's see the graphical representation. To understand it properly, by plotting a graph of vapor pressure, against temperature in Kelvin on x-axis.
Okay, we know that
we obtain two different curves. First curve AB for solvent. We know that solvent has a greater vapor pressure. And the solution has less vapor pressure. CD
is a less vapor pressure
than the solvent.
Okay, it represents two vapor pressure.
Now, when we decrease the temperature,
there is a vapor pressure here.
When we decrease vapor pressure, the solvent starts freezing, and here solution also starts freezing. This is solution. Solution starts freezing. So this represents freezing. So the temperature at which here it starts freezing, so that temperature is the freezing point of your solvent, T0F.
It represented here the depression in freezing point. This is the freezing point where liquid starts or solvent starts freezing.
And here again at the next stage, here solution starts freezing, and that is Tf. Solution starts freezing
and that is Tf.
So at this axis temperature. So Tf represents the freezing point of solution, and here it represents freezing point of solvent. So the difference between these two gives the delta Tf. Here in this case, see, the temperature starts from zero. It increases as to 10, 20, 30, or 1, 2, 3. So it increases. So first, here the freezing point of solvent is less here, and solution is less here, and freezing point of solvent is greater here. So here difference between these gives the delta Tf, and here this red line gives the freezing point of solution and freezing point of solvent here. So from this we can calculate freezing point of solvent is greater. So we minimize lesser value to get the difference. So we get difference here, and we get the vapor pressure, freezing point depression, delta Tf. So this figure indicates depression in freezing point. And similarly, depression in freezing point. So from this depression in freezing point, we must know that another concept, that is delta Tf, is proportional to m, similar to elevation in boiling point. Here depression in freezing point is also proportional to m, molality. Okay, molality, and delta Tf is, when we remove this proportional sign, Kf into m depends on Kf into m. Kf is the depression in freezing point constant. It is a constant term for depression in freezing point, which depends on the
number of solute particles and also some other factors are there. So Kf is the constant here, constant term here. So that constant term here and here the depression in freezing point. Let's see the molality. From the definition of molality, as we know that the number of moles of solute represented by m2 upon m into 1000 divided by the number of moles of mass of solvent in grams. So mass of solvent in grams, so m represented in this way, m2 into 1000 divided by m1 into capital M, m1 into capital M. So this is molality we obtain. Now molality, if we put this value in depression in freezing point, then we get here delta T of equal to K of depression in freezing point constant into m2 into 1000 divided by m1 into small m1 into capital M. So we obtain delta T of. So we if we rearrange for molecular mass of solute, then for m, if we rearrange this equation, we get m equal to K of into m2 into 1000 divided by delta T of goes here, denominator T of into m1. So this equation gives the molar mass of solute, where Kf is the constant, or we say cryoscopic constant. Kf m2 is the molar mass of mass of solute in grams. Here m1 is the mass of solvent in grams. Delta Tf is the elevation in boiling point. So knowing all these terms, we can calculate molar mass of solute. M is the molar mass of solute. We can calculate from all these values molar mass of solute. And this method where we decrease the temperature, and that method is called as cryoscopic method. And previous method in elevation in boiling point we say ebullioscopic method. So this is cryoscopic method for determination of molar mass of solute. So this is about the depression in freezing point, from which we can calculate the molar mass. Also from elevation in boiling point we can calculate molar mass. So we saw colligative properties. There are four colligative properties. First is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Second is the elevation in boiling point. Third is the depression in freezing point. And last colligative property that we have to see is the osmotic pressure. So here from this, it is proportional to M. That means this property is dependent on number of solute particle. Hence number of solute particle, M is the molar concentration. So depends on concentration, depends on number of solute particle. Hence this property is a colligative property. As in the definition we say that this is the colligative property. So in the definition of colligative property we say that the property which depends on number of solute particles, that property is a colligative property. So from this we can say that this property, depression in freezing point, is a colligative property. Let's see the last colligative property, that is osmosis. Last colligative property, that is osmosis. In the osmosis, last colligative property, that is osmosis, osmotic pressure. Before that, starting osmotic pressure, we must know the osmosis term. Okay, osmosis. Osmosis means simply flow of solvent molecule into the solution. Flow of solvent molecule into the solution through semi-permeable membrane. One membrane is there, that is semi-permeable membrane. Permeable membrane is called as osmosis. Okay, so osmosis is the process in which solvent molecule flows through semi-permeable membrane.